happened, and we spoke about the Salat of Fir, and we spoke about Ghawrath, the man that came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and with the sword he asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what prevents me from killing you, Muhammad? And sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah, Allah prevents you from killing me. And the sword dropped from his hand, and then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam held that sword and he said, what prevents me from killing you, Ghawrath? And he said, your generosity, it's your mercy, full. And he forgave him and he let them go. He let him go, and Ghawrath decided to never fight Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam again. At least he had that much wisdom. In the fourth year of Hijrah was the battle of Dumatul Jandal. Dumatul Jandal is a place to the north and a little bit to the east of Medina. And this happened actually in the fifth year of Hijrah, correction. And this is the last battle that happened before the Battle of Al-Khandaq. And this was the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's intelligence gave him the news that the tribes of Dumatul Jandal, and there are many of them, Dumatul Jandal actually is a small town, and there are many tribes around it. So the tribes of Dumatul Jandal were preparing to invade Medina. As we said, many tribes had the illusion that Muslims were defeated in Uhud and now they are an easy prey, and this is a time to hit them while they're weak. So instead of waiting for them, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took 1,000 fighters and headed out to Dumatul Jandal. And Dumatul Jandal people were very surprised by this preemptive attack, and they escaped, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Sahaba, they got some spoils that were left after those people escaped. And while he was there, he had a treaty with Uyayn ibn Husayn, and this treaty it's a non-aggression treaty that they will not attack each other. Now the treaties are different from the treaty that was struck with the Jews of Medina. The treaty with the Jews is a combined defense treaty. Is if we are attacked, you come to our help. If you're attacked, we have to come to your help in Medina. This is a different. This is a non-aggression treaty. We will not attack you on the condition that you do not attack us back. But there's no help. We don't help each other if somebody else is attacked. And we will see why is that important, because this name, Uyayn ibn Husayn, will come on later. Muslims stayed also for days in Dumatul Jandal, challenging those mushriks to come, and no fighting occurred. So, from that we go on to our main objective of our session today, which is the Battle of the Trench. If I can find it. There you go. Ghazwat al-Khandaq, or the Battle of the Trench, happened in the fifth year of Hijrah, and it happened in the month of Shawwal. So immediately after Ramadan, there was a conspiracy cooking in Arabia, and the Muslims were not aware of it at that point. Remember Ghazwat al-Nadir, Ghazwat Bani Nadir. Now the Jews of Bani Nadir that were expelled from Medina, and led by Huyay ibn Akhtab, right? He was the leader of Bani Nadir, and he went where? He went to Khaybar. And he immediately became, him and Salam ibn Abi al-Haqqaiq, most of the leaders of Bani Nadir became the leaders of Khaybar. So they were boiling inside to take revenge from the Muslims and from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that expelled them from Medina. And what they did is Huyay ibn Akhtab took 20 people and they went out on a mission to Mecca. And the mission was to get Quraysh and the tribes around Quraysh and many tribes in Arabia to come as a unit, as an ally unit, allies to fight Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to basically eliminate this Muslim threat in Arabia. So 20 of them went to Mecca, and Abu Sufyan responded very positively after he was humiliated with his fear after that second battle of Badr, where he returned with the army. Then they went to the second largest tribe or actually one of the largest tribes in Najd, which is Ghatafan. Ghatafan had many, many fighters, and they were very huge tribes, and they were known for their skill in war. So Ghatafan also responded to the call of Huyay ibn Akhtab. And then around Ghatafan, from the clans of Ghatafan, Banu Fazara, and they were led by Uyaynah ibn Husayn. And then Banu Murrah, that was led by Al-Harith ibn Auf, and Banu Ashja' by Mus'ar ibn Rukhayla. And then also the tribe of Banu Asad. So five or six tribes from the east side of Najd. And then around Mecca, Quraysh took the people of Kinana and some of the tribes of Tuhama, which is the shore of the Red Sea. So these people, and here is Al-Madinah, and the tribes that came are from the east and from the south. From Mecca, Quraysh took about 400 fighters, 4,000 Mushrik fighters. And Ghatafan and their allies, the other four tribes, were about 6,000, and they came from the east. And the whole movement was coordinated by Huyay ibn Akhtab, by that man from Banu Nadir. And Huyay led them to the mountain of Uhud from both sides. And you see the geography of Medina again. The best place to attack Medina from is the north. The north is geographically opened. The south, the only place that you can attack Medina is from the tribe of Bani Qurayza. Bani Qurayza had this treaty with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this was not a place that they should let anybody in. However, that would become questionable in the course of this battle. So, these 10,000 fighters, they go on, and Al-Madinah get the news that these people are coming. They get the intelligence that the Jewish tribe of Banu Nadir have got this coalition together, and there's a huge army. Now the entire population of Medina all together, counting the elderly, the children, and the women, was not up to 10,000 at that time. So this is a huge army. This is a major threat coming towards Medina. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam got the Sahaba together, got the leaders of the Sahaba together, and he started asking them, what should we do? Going out is not a very good option, as we saw in the Battle of Uhud. That really makes them a very easy target. We see the Muslim army that gathered was 3,000, and that was the largest Muslim army to that point. That was everybody, basically. So the army gets out in the desert, then may be an easier prey for these 10,000. And these 10,000 were in two separate armies where they can trap the Muslims easily. So there were many suggestions, but Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam listened to a suggestion that was not familiar to the Arabs at that time, and that came from the Sahabi, from the companion Salman al-Farisi. Salman was from Persia. And what he said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كُنَّا بِأَرْضِ فَارِسِ. When we were in Persia, إِذَا حُصِرْنَا, and when we are besieged, when we have many armies coming to attack us in our town, خَنْدَقْنَا عَلَيْنَا, that we would dig a trench around us, so nobody can come, and coming to us would become a lot harder. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam liked that idea of the trench, and he decided to build the trench across the north. And for that, is obviously, you cannot build a trench around the entire Medina in a short period of time. That would be impractical. But you can actually take this length, which is around 3 miles to the north, that you can take that and build a trench very fast. And for that, he got 1,000 workers, thousands of the Sahabi, to help him, and he was with them. And for 10 men, they were giving the mission to dig 40 yards. Each 10 men were given 40 yards to dig. And the trench was supposed to be, and it was, a width of that about 9 yards, and the depth of it between 7 to 10 yards. Something that people cannot jump across, and horses cannot jump across. That's the main thing. So, as these armies getting close, and Khuwayy ibn Akhtab put them where he thought that they would just trap the Medina, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam started working on the trench. In al-Bukhari, Sahl ibn Sa'd narrates that we were with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was with us, and the Sahaba were all digging in the ground, digging up the trench, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam with us, getting the dirt and the soil up on our shoulders and on our backs. And Rasulullah sallallahu, they were singing this song to help him, this chanting to help him. It's called Ar-Rajaz. It's not really poetry, but it's a